ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. హరి ఓం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత ఫస్ట్ చాప్టర్ వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 36. తస్మాన్నార్హా వయం హంతుం ధార్తరాష్ట్రాన్ సబాంధవాన్ స్వజనం హి కథం హత్వా సుఖిన శ్యామ మాధవ. జస్ట్ అర్జున కంటిన్యూయింగ్ టు లార్డ్ కృష్ణ. ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ ఎపిసోడ్ వి వర్ డిస్కసింగ్ అబౌట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ధర్మ, బికాస్ అర్జున స్పీక్స్ అబౌట్ పాప అండ్ పుణ్య. By killing these wrong doers, we will definitely own papa. Now that is true. What he says is true, and dharma also says it. If you kill somebody, you will be affected papa. Okay? But not for a king, not for the sake of dharma. He applied a rules means about dharma. He applied that law of dharma in wrong place. Therefore, dharma is to be interpreted according to the context. That's what we discussed a lot. Finally, we concluded in the last episode, whatever the karmas are introduced and unfolded by Vedas and Agamas and Puranas. I made it Veda, Agama, Purana because these Puranas, Agamas and all of there are so many other sources like Upavedas, Upaveda, Angas, all of them, they just incur the knowledge of Vedas. Okay. Therefore, we can say the karma which are unfolded by Vedas, they only give punya. The action which gives punya can be called dharma. Therefore, you know, constructing a temple is dharma. Doing puja is dharma. Doing japa, dhyana means meditation. And having parayana, mere recitation. See, when you recite this Bhagavad Gita as a parayana, you finish 18 chapter, you will be achieving punya. That's the speciality. When you read the Sundara Kandam of Ramayana, so you are provided punya phala. See, mere japa will bring punya phala. And in simple way, doing namaskara, providing food for others, and even watering the plants and providing water to the animals, feeding birds, all these are called punya karyam. Okay, now where there is a rules, there is also a regulation of those rules. You know, that's what we concluded in the last session. For example, ahimsa paramo dharmaha. Ahimsa, not doing any himsatmakam karyam, not disturbing others' life, is called, you know, paramo dharmaha. But it is interpreted in different context. Take a knife, cut somebody's hand. It's ahimsa. You will be affected by papa. But the same thing, if it is performed or done by the doctor in order to save that life, that person's life, then it is converted as punya. Therefore, I said the intention does the matter. If at all that patient, he died after the operation. Because by God's grace, every operation must be successful. That's what our prayer is. But here, this is the teaching we have to understand properly. If a doctor performs operation, if it goes wrong, he is not punished. He won't be punished, he won't be affected by papa. That's what the dharma is. But he had intention to protect the life. He tried hard, he gave 100% his knowledge and work to that matter for that operation, means that is enough. In the same way, when you are a king, these kings are protectors of dharma. They have a duty to protect dharma. So whoever protects dharma, they are protected. That's what this line, dharma rakshati rakshitaha. When you protect dharma, you will be protected by punya karya. But when somebody, because our nation is giving priority for dharma karya, now the king has the duty to protect dharma. If somebody is violating dharma, disturbing dharma, then this king has to fight with him. By even if he loses his life, doesn't matter. If he loses life here, he will be provided a proper punya phala to have a proper life hereafter. That's what Krishna says, hato va prapsyasi svargam jitva va bhokshase mahim. That's what he says. You know, if you are defeated, means you are killed, definitely you will be given heaven life. If you got victory, then what? You will be a king and you will enjoy this kingdom. That's what the language of Krishna is. Now, being a king means Arjuna, he should not allow this Duryodhana to commit papa. If he is not killing him, he will continuously committing papa, which would be the violation of dharma. The law, if Arjuna is not killing Duryodhana, somebody else will kill definitely. Therefore what? Now you have got the charge. That's what Krishna will say later. But because of the wrong understanding, now he has pity on this opposite person. Arjuna was not a sannyasi and Arjuna was not also jnani. He was not atma sadhaka. At that time he has the duty to protect dharma, therefore he has to fight there. So instead of doing that, he says that these people are our own people. By killing those people, definitely we will, you know, get sin, you know. And that too, these people are my own people. He is so confused. He sometimes says my own people, and also he says atatayinaha. Therefore this Janardana, Madhusudana means Krishna. Krishna has got innumerable names. This Janardana is asuranam jananam narakadi gamayatratvat Janardana ityuchate. One who sends all these asuras to naraka, that person is called Janardana. There was an asura called Janardana. Okay. Then Madhusudana. And he killed a slayer of a demon called asura. And one more in-depth meaning for this Madhusudana. That is, you know, very beautiful. Madhu means what? Usually we say honey. Honey is called madhu. But the nearest a person can be also called madhu. Now Shastra questions us, who is very close to you, very near, very dearest to you? Then don't think about somebody else outside. So here, inside, because we are very dear to our ahankara, ego, we hold our ego, we don't want to lose. We want to nourish the ego. Even in the name of Dharma, who nourishes the ego, he will be kept away from punya. Therefore, the attitude is very important with every karma. Now, this madhu means here ahankara, that person who has got victory or who has slayed that ahankara, because that is the first step to get progress, to get entry in the spiritual path. Therefore, he is called Madhusudana. And this Krishna, he kept quiet here. And this Krishna keeps quiet, Arjuna, again he continues.
Yadyap yetena pasyanti lobho pahata cetasah kulakshayakritam dosham mitradrohe cha patakam.
Now, after analysis of Dharma, with that norms of Dharma, we have to have the perception, these all forthcoming verses. That's what we made it very clear, what is Dharma. Okay, Dharma needs to be interpreted according to the context. He says, yadyapi, even if these people are not worrying about the destruction which will be taking place after the war. Okay, and they don't, because they were friends, it's like, you know, it's cheating of friends. They don't know all this Duryodhana, etc. people, they don't worry, they don't care about Dharma, they don't care about a good relationship, friendship, they cheat. And they also distract all this posterity. If we continue with the war, there will be drastic destruction. Because all males are here, females are left alone, and children will be left alone. They will lose their fathers. In those days where there is no man, no dharma karya can be performed. Therefore, they will be left alone. Kulakshayam bhavati. Kulam means the posterity, means we call it a lineage of family system. All these, you know, this mistake we should not make, because this Duryodhana, etc. people, they are greedy people. Lobha upahata chetaha. Lobhena upahataha. They are occupied or overwhelmed by greed. They don't have the attitude to see what is going on. But we are not like that. We should not be so.
Katham nagneyam asmabhihi papadasman nivartitum kulakshayakritam dosham prapashyad bhyarjanardana.
They are not aware about a certain dharma concept, therefore, according to them, that is okay for us. But for us, we are knowledgeable people. Asmabhihi, asmat papat nivartitum, katham iti jnyeyam. I don't find any other way to escape from this papa. I don't want to commit papa. Now the word, see, we have to live a life. That life should only be endowed with dharma karya to earn punya. Or everybody, we should have a fear that we should not commit unknowingly or knowingly we should not commit papa. That's what he brings here, but in wrong place. He forgot, just forgot he was a king, he has the duty, and he forgot 13 years he lived and waited for this moment. Now he is giving all the reason, means what? His escapism, he wants to escape from the battle. Something went wrong, he was not ready. He was just keep on adding all the reasons from the Shastra. Kulakshaya means where there is no males, no dharma can be performed, said in Dharma Shastra. He brings that point to justify his escapism. And also he continues, when Kula becomes distracted, then what? See, all those other destruction will come. That's what he narrates it. We will read it. Kula kshaye pranashyanti kula dharma sanatanaha dharme nashte kulam kritnam adharmo bhibhavatyuta. Adharma bhibhavat krishna pradushyanti kulastriyaha striyashu dushtasu varshneya jayate varna sankaraha. If this lineage is broken, then what? All these, the rituals will be disconnected. Sanatanaha kula dharmaha pranashyanti. Because as our forefathers, every family, we had a kind of puja system. We used to, means still we are worshipping kula devatas. Kula devata means every family has got the deity to worship. And even we have three kinds of gods. Ishta devata, kula devata, para devata. Ishta devata means the deity which I like. I like Lord Krishna. I like Lord Rama. So even, you know, you may like Lord Krishna or Rama, but your kula devata may be something different. You have to worship, that puja has to be continued for the welfare of your family and your children. That's what kula devata puja. We are very sure, but nowadays we are losing that belief system, not knowing, because we are not aware about adrishta. We have to be endowed with adrishta. Life is completely governed by adrishta. Now whatever that sentence comes from my mouth, it's because of something I might have done punya. Because I can deal with the shastra, that's a gift, bhagyam. I have to be with a proper attitude. I should not have ahankara that I am teaching. No. Because of God's gifts. Some gurus, all my gurus anugraha, I am given a chance to teach or share my knowledge which is provided by gurus. That the attitude I should have. In the same way, when we worship Kula Devata, we should know this, the truth of Adrashtam, that will protect. Those Kula Devatas, then there are Ishta Devatas. Ishta Devatas means the God which I like, I love. Even in the Krishna, people like with float. And many of us, sometimes we are told, you know, one should not have Krishna with flute at home. One person asked, Swamiji, is it true? Should we not have Krishna with flute at home? Then I said, who said it? No, somebody told. Okay, then what kind of Krishna we can have? Swamiji, you know, the Krishna, one who does upadesha in the battlefield, that Krishna also should not be at home. Okay, then what kind of Krishna you like? We should have a Radhe Krishna. Wow, what the romance. Of course, Krishna is all alone, he is Krishna alone. The flute Krishna, Radhe Krishna, Bhagavad Gita Krishna. So three of them are one and the same. But if you like the Krishna with flute, you can definitely have at your home as the Ishta Devata. But don't give up Kula Devata Puja. The worshipping Kula Devata must be continued with. But Ishta Devata also you can worship, keep worshipping. And according to your placement, where you live, if there are some temples, festivals on, you can also visit those temples to have a proper worship. It can be other deity than your Kula Devata and Ishta Devata. That's known as Paradevata. Every city, every town should have a temples. Then there are festivals, they have to be participated by us. We should not quit. So that is not my Ishta Devata. No, nothing wrong in it. You should go and attend that, participate that festivals. These worships are because they are completely adrishtam. And going to the temple, please don't quit it. If at all you don't have time, make time for that. Don't stop it. And we should have temple at home. We should have prayer hall, shrine, small shrine. Doesn't matter how big or how small, doesn't matter, but we should have. Keep doing puja, because everything is connected with adrishta. Even showing the arati, people, they don't know what the truth behind the arati. But if, don't worry if you don't know the factor behind that action, but just get it done. This is like, you know, having food. Whether you know about the food completely, what kind of vitamins, nourishments it contains, if I consume it, what kind of energies I will get, vitamin A, B, C or D, no. The body has the capacity to consume it. In the same way, whether you know the meaning, factors behind every rituals, just follow it with a proper attitude, means faith. Follow it. That's what our dharma is. So now here he says, kula dharma, if kula dharma means if male are slayed, then the people will be left alone. Then what? Kula kshayam bhavati, the lineage will be disconnected, broken. Then there won't be dharma karya. If there is no dharma karya, means all pralaya will come. Then all strees, means ladies and children, all this, you know, they will be left alone. Then is it necessary for us? He continues, Sankaro naraka yaiva kulagnanam kulasya cha patanti pitaro hesham lupta pindoda kakriya. He brings very serious issue now. He says, if these people die, then nobody will be left to give this tarpana, shraddha, etc. See, how far he thinks about it. He don't want to fight, but he brings all this proper knowledge from Dharma Shastra, from Vedas. Because when somebody dies, he should be given proper ritual. That rituals you may not understand. The science may not enough evidence to find the factors behind these rituals. Doesn't matter. Just get it done. Because all these science people, means a scientist, they dig to find out these factors behind these actions. It will take, you know, years, decades, thousands of hundreds of years. We need not to wait until for that time. Just you get it done. Therefore, Tarpana, every Amavasya day, you are getting connected with your forefathers. And the same Dharma which has the duty only when you are grihastha. If you have taken sannyasa, no, this kind of duty. Sannyasis, they have one more, that's a different thing. But you need not to do tarpana. Because while taking sannyasa, you give atmapinda for your sacred self. Because this physical and subtle and causal system must be respected. Sannyasi who denies pinda, no, it's not like that. Sannyasi, he gives all this ashtashrardha. He does all the shrardhas for father too in the beginning, ancient time. Whatever these ancestors he belonged to, he get it done for everybody. And he also gives tarpana, means pinda, for his own body, mind and sense complex. That's what it's a fantastic, because everything is adrashtam. Adrashtam means which cannot be seen, but they are the laws. That we will see in the next episode. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.